So I'm a YouTuber and I used to upload a lot of videos based on home automation projects. So I tried to combine both of them and made my own YouTube controlled home automation project in which you all people who are watching my videos can actually control the appliances in my studio just like this.
Light two off kiya kisine. Okay, light 3 on bhi kisne kiya hai, light 3 on ho chuki hai, those were the light 3 connected common, and koi light 4 on kar do, to ye light bhi on ho jayegi. Light kisne kya kiya bhai, light 4 on kari kisne, this is the light 4 which turned on right now. Kaisa laga ye project, now you believe this is a real working project and you are controlling these lights from the YouTube live chat.
Interesting, isn't it? So in this video, I'm gonna teach you all the steps required to make this complete project on your own. So now before starting this video, if you are watching me for the very first time, well, consider subscribing this channel as I used to come up with these kind of innovative ideas and projects in the field of IoT, home automation and electronics. Well, that being said, let's start with YouTube controlled home automation project. Thoda sa weird hai, but kafi kuch naya seekhne ko milega. So let's get started. Do you know what most electronic companies have something in common? Well, it's the tool that they use for making their products, and the most commonly used tool that almost all the big electronic companies uses is the LTM PCB designer software. Using LTM, you can definitely level up your PCB designing skills and make something really professional out of it. And now, along with the integration of Octopart, searching for any electronic components globally becomes really very easy. Octopart is kind of Google for just electronic components, where you can search for any electronic parts and get that information all on one single web page. So do check out this amazing search engine made just for electronic components. I'll leave the link for this down in the description. Do check it out. Okay, so first of all, if you're thinking from where I got this idea, well, I got this idea while watching porn. Hey, what? Yes, like even while watching porn, I used to get project ideas, like how obsessed I am with this field of electronics. But anyways, so in that website, the content creator goes live in that platform and do all the tasks, and we as a user can watch the content creator and can interact with that creator using the live chat, you know, interface, just like the YouTube live videos. But what different they did here is they introduced a token system where a user like us can buy the tokens and can give those tokens to that content creator through that live chat platform only. And as soon as that token are received by that content creator, there are some kind of vibration happens to the IoT device, which is directly attached to the content creator. I hope you're understanding the point. And I was like, wow, this is a great IoT device. Like, we can control that IoT device, or rather give commands to that device through a live chat platform from any corner of the world. It was really very interesting, at least for me. So I thought, why not try this on YouTube, like controlling an IoT device via YouTube platform. So I started my research on this YouTube APIs, and luckily I found that YouTube do provide this kind of APIs where we can fetch the data of the live chat and use it for whatever we want. So for further research, I gave this task to Ritesh, and he came up with an amazing Python library that is totally made for this particular application. So now let's go onto our computer and see how to use that library and how to use that particular live chat data. So the library which we are going to use for a project is this PYT chat library. And as the description says, the PYT chat is a Python library for fetching YouTube live chat. And this is what exactly we want. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll open up the terminal of my Mac system. Now, let me tell you here, I'm using my Mac system, which already have Python built in, but you can also use Windows system, but you need to install first of all Python in it. And then you can follow the same, you know, commands and script. And you can also use the Raspberry Pi board, which also has a built-in Python in it, and you can follow the same commands and it will work in Python as well. Okay, so to install this PYT chat library, I'll type the command pip3 install PYT chat, press enter. And as you can see, it says requirement already satisfied. That means my system already have this library. In your case, it will be already automatically installed. So yeah, this is the only thing we need for our project. And after that, we can, you know, copy the sample code, which is provided here in it. The sample script, you can say, and I'll open a you know, code editor. In my case, I'm using the Sublime text editor. You can use any code editor of your choice. I'll paste that script here, and here in the script, we just need to change one thing, which is the video ID. Now, each YouTube video has a unique video ID, and here we need to provide that ID so that this script will fetch the messages from that particular live video only. Okay, so for that what I'll do is I open up the youtube.com website, and here I'll search for live videos. Okay, let me just filter it out for live videos only, and let's go to this live video, maybe a random live video. Okay, so anyone can comment in this particular thing, pretty good. So I'll skip the ad, and as you can see, this is a random live video running, which is about live airport action. That's a random live video, no problem. So it gets it. So to get it ID, you just need to click on the URL, and this is that particular ID, video ID, you can say. I'll copy it and I'll straight away paste that here, and that's pretty much it. I'll save this script into my downloads folder with the name as YouTube. Or firstyoutubelive.py. That's it. Saved in my download folder. Done. Now let's just open up the terminal. And first of all, let me just go to my downloads folder. Okay. Now here I'll just type the command Python 3, and the name of the video was firstyoutubelive.py. I'll press enter, and the script started running. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll just okay, so there are a couple of guidelines to be fulfilled here, but no problem. I'll just type hello from Sachin, press enter, and I already got a lot of messages here. But as you can see, at this particular time period, techiesms sent the message called as hello from Sachin. As you can see, all the messages are printed once it is written in this chat section. As you can see, I am also doing well, thank you for asking, which is printed here. Okay, so we can fetch all the messages that are written in that particular chat of that live video. As you can see, one by one we are getting all the data, and we can use this data for whatever we want. I'll stop running this script, and we can edit this script as well. Like, let me tell you how we can use the data. So first of all, I just print the name separately and the message separately. For that, I will use the function print double inverted comma name, then comma c dot author dot name. So using c.author.name, we can print the name of the author, like who is typing the message, and after that we can see that actual message with c.message. Great. I'll save this script, and now if I run this script, it will properly print the name of that person who is typing the message and the actual message. Okay, there is some error here in the line 7. Chat object has no attribute. Okay, so there is some typo error. So here I just need to type author, and I'll save that. I'll run that again, and it started running. Okay, let's just wait for someone to type any message. Okay, so already people are typing the message. Okay, as you can see, one by one we are getting all the data. The name is Justin Reynolds, and he types the message, lol, I love Turkey and everything. Then we have Tom Duffy, which says beautiful day. Let me just type my message here. This is Sachin Soni. I'll press enter, and hopefully I should get that message. Okay, so name is techiesms, which is the account name, and this is the message, this is Sachin Soni. I'll stop running this script. So this is how we can use both the data separate, the name of the person and the message which is typed by that particular person. Okay, so now let us use this data to do something meaningful. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll go to this particular script here. I'll open up this example code called as YouTube One Light. Now what I'm gonna do is here in my studio there are a couple of lights which are controlled via internet with the help of Blynk IoT cloud. Okay, so I made the hardware, I written the code for it, and able to control that using the Blynk application. I already uploaded the video of that particular hardware and programming and whose link is down in the description. So in that video I shown everything about the hardware, like how I made the hardware for controlling 4 lights and 1 fan, and I also shown how to write the code for it. And in the end of the video, I controlled 4 lights and speed of 1 AC fan using the mobile application. Okay, so that project I'll be using here, but this time rather than controlling with the Blynk mobile application, I'll be controlling the same appliances with the help of YouTube live chat. Okay, so one thing which we are going to use here is the Blynk API. So in that video we control with the Blynk mobile application, but now we'll be taking the help of the Blynk APIs which we're going to embed in this particular script. So first let me tell you what is a Blynk API and how does it works. Okay, so for that I'll open a new tab and just type as Blynk API. It will open up a documentation. So here is the HTTP Blynk APIs, and I need to write the data to the pin. So I'll open up update data stream value, and here is the example API link of Blynk. Okay, so I'll copy this and I'll paste it in a new page. And here, first of all, we need to write down the server name. So in my case, the server is blr1.blynk.cloud. In your case, it may be different. To check out the server name, you just need to go to the blynk.cloud website and just log into your account. And on the bottom corner, as you can see, it is written as BLR1 in my case, and hence I have written as BLR1. In your case, it may be a different server. So just change the server here. After that, just go to the project based upon which those lights are controlled. Okay, so in my case, it is controlled using the smallest home automation project. I'll go to device info and I'll simply copy this authentication token. I'll copy that and I'll paste that token here. And here I'll mention the pin. So I want to control the virtual pin V0, and I want to send the data as 1. So by sending data 1, I can turn on the light. So let me just open up my smartphone's camera to show you how this is working. Okay, so I'll turn on the recording. So those were the lights which are controlled using the Blynk application, and here is the Blynk API. So I'll press enter here, and as you can see, the as you will be seeing that the light will get turned on. Let me just press enter. Oh, can't find the server. Okay, I just need to type here as cloud/external. Okay, so I'll request the link and let's see what happens. As you can see, the light got turned on, and if I just make it 0, as you can see, the light got turned off. Similarly, I can turn on other light as well by changing the virtual pin number. Let me just turn on the virtual pin V1 light. As you can see, that light also got turned on, and I can turn it off. So with this APIs, we can easily control the lights, and we can request this APIs from any device that has internet access. So I will be implementing or embedding this API links into a Python script, and we'll be triggering this API links based upon the chat that we are getting from that YouTube live video. Okay, so I'll simply copy it, or rather I already embedded in that particular script. Let me just go through that script. So yeah, here is that script that controlled one light using the live chat API. Okay, so here in this script, I provided an if condition in which I am checking whether the message has on in all capital letters or on in all small letters. So whatever message I'm receiving, I will just print as LED on, and I'll request one API to turn on the light at virtual pin V0. And similarly, if the message is off, I'm printing as LED off, and I'm also requesting a link to turn off that LED by providing the data 0. Okay, now here I have used one more library called as request, which you need to install first of all, and its installation is also pretty common. You just need to type as pip3 install and requests, press enter. In my case, it's already satisfied. I already installed it, but in your case, you need to type this command to install this library. And after you successfully install it, you are good to go. Okay, I'll just change this video ID as well in this particular script. Okay, I'll paste that here. So our script is ready. So this script will help us to control one light by just typing the command on or off in that particular live video. Let's just test it out. I'll save the script. It goes by the name YouTube_onelight. So I'll write a command. Let's just clear everything. I'll write a command python3 and the name YouTube1light.py. I'll press enter, and the script started running. Okay, I'm getting the messages from all the other person who are commenting on that live chat. I'll turn on my smartphone's camera as well, just to let you see everything is working or not. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll go to this live chat, and here I'll just type O and on, and let's just see what happens. Okay, as you can see, it says LED on, and the light in my studio turned on, which is awesome, right? Let me just type it off and let's see what happens. Okay, so now I'll type off here, and okay, it says LED off, and the LED in my studio got turned off. So I am able to control this light using the YouTube live chat on YouTube platform. Isn't this crazy? Now let's just make it way more useful and let's just try to control all the four lights separately with a separate command. Let's just try it out. So here for controlling the four lights, what I did is I just copied and pasted all the if conditions, and here I just changed the message as light one on in all capitals and light one on in all smalls. Okay, so if I'm getting this data, I'm turning on the light at virtual pin V0, and similarly if I'm getting light one off, I'm just turning off the light at virtual pin V0, and similarly I did for all the four lights. Okay, so this time I just changed the message to be written onto the live chat. Okay, that's pretty much it. Let's just make this YouTube video the same for the script as well. Okay, and I'll just save the script, and this script goes by the name YouTube_4Lights. Let me just go to the terminal and just change this to 4, and if I press enter, okay, there's an error. Okay, it's 4 lights. So I'll run this script YouTube4lights.py and let us test it out. I'll turn on the smartphone's camera to let you see all the things working live in action. Okay, so here are all the 4 lights in off condition as of now. So here, first of all, I'll type the command light one space on, and if I press enter, okay, so the light one should get turned on. As you can see, the first light got turned on, and similarly I can turn on other lights as well. Let's turn on the light 4. I'll just type light 4 on, and if I click on the send button, as you can see, the fourth light also got turned on. So I can control multiple lights using this particular a video. Like on YouTube, I can type the commands to turn on and off any particular lights. As you can see, the fourth light got turned off. So this was a demo of how you can use the YouTube live chat APIs to do the IoT task. Okay, so this is not for home automation, of course. Like, who would be using a home automation to be controlled using a YouTube live video? So this was just a proof of concept, but what I'm going to make using this is really very interesting, and you'll love it for sure. Let me share you why I made this project and what's the purpose of it and where I'm going to use it. But before that, if you already loved the concept, yeah, mujhe to bahut sahi laga. So if you also loved this concept, find it something unique or interesting, bhai, like daba do yaar, do click the like button and batao YouTube ko ki this is an amazing video jo aapne pehle kabhi bhi nahi dekhi. Do click the like button and comment below, kaisa laga aapko ye concept? Did you find it interesting? And are you getting some crazy ideas using this particular concept? Any project that you're going to make, also let me know down in the comments of the video. And now let me share what I'm going to make with this. So I'm going to use this concept of controlling IoT devices using YouTube live chat APIs to run a contest for a giveaway on my channel. So as you can see, we are soon going to reach the 100k mark. Yeah, subscribe kar do to make that 100k mark as soon as possible. Okay, so we are soon going to reach that 100k mark, and I was thinking to do a giveaway on, like, after reaching the 100k mark on this particular channel, and using this particular concept, I'll be deciding the winners of the giveaway. So as of now, I have a rough idea about, like, I can run a contest on the live session on my channel, and you all people participating in it through the YouTube chat. Okay, so whosoever maybe gives the answer first wins the game, or maybe I'll run a script to randomly pick the winner from the YouTube live chat APIs, and its name will be displayed on the Python script, and maybe we can blast the studio with his IoT device, maybe turn on the lights, maybe we can do anything. I haven't decided this, like, what I'm going to do, but I am going to use this concept to select the giveaway winner, that is for sure. Okay, so as soon as we reach the 100k mark, after that I'll do that live session in which you will be selecting the winners using this particular concept used in this video. So for that purpose, I was thinking of to develop this kind of thing, and yeah, we already did it. I hope you like this concept. I hope this was something new which you haven't heard it anywhere or haven't experienced of. So yeah, that was it about the video. I hope you like it, I hope you enjoyed it, I hope you learned something new from it. And yeah, that being said, I am just ending this video here, and now just wait for my next one, then explore, learn, share with me, techiesms.